Hey guys, what's going on? Welcome back to a brand new video. And I just recently finished my custom Sinister 6. So just to get the official minifigures out of the way, which will be Electro. And Doc Ock. The one change I did to him was I just gave him black arms instead of the light gray ones. So yeah. Alright, so now let's just get right on to this review. So Shocker was one of the most hardest minifigures I had to make. Basically, everything you see here is fully, completely painted by me. The head was originally just some random yellow head where I erased the second face off the back, and then I just drew the brown thing. By the way, this is his design from the Amazing Spider-Man 2 video game. Then I proceeded to draw the eyes and the eye, basically the half mask. The torso was completely painted by me as well, with brown paint and two straps. Also, you can't clearly see it, but there's like a little bit of quilts on there. The arms as well also have quilts, and there's a neck brace because he sort of had like a backpack in the video game. The legs are the one thing that's not painted by me. Now let's move on to his gauntlets. The gauntlets were made from Chima pieces that I cut the bottom end off so they can fit. Again, these are just cut handcuff pieces, which you can easily use with scissors. So that's it for Shocker. So next off, we got the Vulture. I decided to give him the Spectacular Spider-Man design, where basically I just gave him a black torso and I painted some red on there, along with black arms, black legs, falcon wings, as he did have red wings in the series, and that's Magneto's head, but with the second face erased. I really wish I erased the first face. Moving along, we got Sandman. Sandman was one of the most easiest figures to make. I decided to go with the dark green and the white rather than dark green and light green. So I thought it blended in way better. Of course, I painted it on the back and as well as the front. Green arms, brown legs, and the official Sandman head and hair. So I thought that looked pretty nice. Finally, we got the Rhino. He's actually a brick-built fig. So basically what I did was I took the Hulkbuster, took off anything that said flat-out Iron Man, and made custom-made arms. Basically, that spider thing, which you can find in the same set that Electro comes in, also is from Spider-Man's bike. And the guns are easily just won by four, I guess, bricks. The other arms are the same procedure, but two guns and no star. And then the head's just the official brick-build Rhino's head, but with a different horn piece. There's no guy in there because sadly I cannot easily fit him, but oh well. Anyways guys, I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure you leave a like, comment, share this, and subscribe. See you next time. Bye guys!